This was awkward. I knew the man next to me was a cold-blooded killer, but there was little I can do while riding shotgun in his deathmobile, currently rocketing along the highway at 70 miles per hour. Just because I see the dead, doesn't mean I'm interested in joining their ranks anytime soon.
Eat anything today?
And so I bravely made idle conversation.
Roadside diner about 5 miles back. Pancakes.
Any good?
All pancakes are good.
But were they particularly good?
I'm not one to speak ill of another man's pancakes, but truth be told, they lacked fluffiness.
And fluffiness is important.
Fluffiness is key.
I'll be sure to remember that.
I needed physical proof of this man's nefarious activities. The authorities, those sticklers for rules and regulations, still insisted that their witnesses be living and visible.
I can take you as far as Montville. I just have to pick up something at home first.
Of course.
Luckily, it looked like I was about to get my proof firsthand. The smart thing would be to run. But if I didn't stop him, this man would kill again. Besides, she deserved justice. Peace.
I'll be back in a jiffy.
Bodox. I had seen their kind before. Like the dead, they were invisible to everyone but me. Bodox appeared only before soul-shattering, catastrophic events. Mass murders. Terrorist attacks. Your average movie of the week serial killer wouldn't do the trick. They may have been evil harbingers of doom, but Bodox had standards. Which begged the question, what made this guy so special? Unless it wasn't him, could they possibly be gathering here to watch me die? Why would my death be more important than anyone else's?
Everything all right, Odd? They're beautiful, aren't they?